Ladies and gentlemen, the University of California Band proudly presents the 1977 Spring Musical Review. Getting on those steps better, you are not going to get into the show, okay?
Who am I anyway? Am I my resume? That is a picture of a person I don't know. Does he want from me? What should I try to be? So many people all around, and here we go. I need this job. Oh God, I need this.
Okay, Sasha. Come on,
great to be back home. On the stage is home to us. When it's us up here and you out there, we're contented as a band's got a right to be. It's the same old story, everywhere we go. We get happy, happy. We mean the very meaning of happy. My abuelo suit, my shoes shine. If anybody says to me what's my life, well, let's keep it the customer satisfied, satisfied. Might have gone to San Jose when I was there for that farm. I might have ate smug at USC. But what in the world would we be down there for when we're in our glory, putting on a show? We get happy, happy. We never mean enough happy. We wear those shoes that's on. Little outside bus snaps on. We find that we're happily occupied, trying to keep the customer satisfied. Keeping the customer satisfied, satisfied. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
And now, from Berkeley, California, under the direction of Robert O. Briggs with drum major Jim Gaston, here's the Pace Setter College Marching Band, the Pride of California, the University of California Marching Band. Thank you. The California Band in Concert. In the 1860s, a competition was held for the design of a gate to the Russian city of Kiev. Artist Victor Hartmann submitted his plan for a gate in the shape of a massive battle helmet. And while no gate was ever built, the picture remained among Hartmann's drawings to be seen by his friend Modest Mussorgsky at an exhibition of these pictures in 1874. Inspired, the musician composed a stirring climax to what has become one of the most famous suites ever written. The University of California Band now presents, from Pictures at an Exhibition, Modest Mussorgsky's Great Gate of Kiev. Ladies and gentlemen, the director of the University of California Band, Mr. Robert O. Briggs. Thank you.
Thank you.
The following is a presentation of BLA Sports.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Giuseppe Pasquino and Joe Balsam here at the LA Coliseum. It's the traditional rivalry between USC and UCLA. And although both teams have failed to show, the refs have decided to score the game at 35. On then to the halftime entertainment with the brassy, solid gold sound of the UCLA Bruin Marching Band. The band is presently moving onto the field, so let's go down and check out the action. Just fabulous, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, I must agree. Although, I would have liked to see more of their famous four-man squad drills.
Yes, quite. Giuseppe, we just had a bulletin that the halftime score of the Stanford-Cal game is 23. So let's take you now to Memorial Stadium in Berkeley with Harry Palms.
Yes, this is Harry Palms at the big game in Berkeley. Down on the field, the Leland Stanford Junior, pardon me, the Leland Junior. This is Harry Palms at the big game in Berkeley. Down on the field, the Leland Stanford Junior. Ah, shoot, the Stanford fans on the field. With our first song, How Can I Miss You When You Won't Go Away? The incomparable Stanford band now plays their own arrangement of Love Is Blue while forming a map of the United States. Streets while forming the Palo Alto turnoff. Wasn't that diamond drill just fabulous, Hugo? Hugo. A report from Joe Balsam down at the Coliseum. The halftime festivities are continuing. Joe, are you there?
Joe Balsam here. Harry, that Stanford band sure does some crazy stuff. Here we are back at the LA Coliseum, patiently awaiting the arrival of the USC Trojan Marching Band. While we're waiting, Giuseppe's got some scores from around the world. Giuseppe?
Yes, Joe. From Taiwan, 35 to 22. From Mozambique, 15 to 8. And here's a late partial score from Tierra del Fuego, 3.
Sure. Yes, now we can hear the rumbling of drums from the tunnel. Yes, yes, here is the USC Trojan Marching Band! One of the more spectacular entrances I've seen today, and there goes the charming couple. Is that?
yes, I have to agree. The USC band now presents a special treat for the audience. Four USC alumni who have recently made it big in the entertainment world are here today to perform with the band. First they gave you Tower Power, then Diana Ross, still later, John Wayne, and now... Band's budget was cut in half this year and will have to survive on a mere $200,000 unless it receives a few small contributions. You can send your check or money order to the USC Band Swiss bank account, Los Angeles, California. You'll be glad you did. Well, with the halftime festivities at a close here at the Coliseum, let's return to Berkeley and Harry Palms.
Yes, Harry Palms back here in Berkeley, California. To conclude today's halftime show, BLA Sports now brings you the pace setter of college marching band finales. Through the decades, the Cal Band has brought us cannons, explosions, bombs, and smoke. You've seen banners of every shape and size and description. We've seen sharks and firebirds, and even been entertained by Dudley Do-Right. Now, in a better-than-ever effort, the Cal Band goes for all the marbles, combining every finale they've done for the past 20 years. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the University of California Marching Band pulls out all the stops with its multi-traditional rendition of Kiev Rhapsody of the 1812 Battle Overture to the end of the three-piece suite for the New World Firebird Night Symphony in the combined mass band arrangement for piccolos and sousaphones for the greater enjoyment, dedication to green grass and blue sky everywhere, and greater promotion to Elvin Munchkins, in addition to a happy salute to Purple King. We'll be right back.
This has been a presentation of BLA Sports. Please stay tuned for this important message. For our live audience, there will be a 10-minute intermission.